in his
life. And we're very glad that today was the day that we chose to get it over with, because we wouldn't want to go up after a night like tonight and try to attempt it.
We are the first group from that jet, the Aleutian cargo plane that brought us here from Puerto Armenes, Chile. There were, I think, something like, 35 Vinson hopefuls on that plane. And we're a relatively small group, two guides and six climbers. Some of them are bigger groups with something like four guides and 16 clients. But they're way behind us. Basically, what they did today is what we did 2 days ago. And it means that their first day for a Vinson approach probably wouldn't be until 2 days, the day after tomorrow. And the clock is ticking. We were the first summiters in 2005, we're pretty sure. The other thing we're going to investigate is whether or not Peter is the youngest summiter of Vinson in history. And that's possible. So today was, wow, the weather was unbelievable. The winds at the summit were what were they, Peter?
I'd say the winds were, some gusts went up to 70 plus miles per hour.
I think we had a consistent, 40 or 50 miles an
hour.
And then we had minus 30 in real temperature Fahrenheit. So the wind chill was, somebody said that was minus 100. I haven't confirmed that. But it was outrageous. We really had difficulty holding on to ourselves from being blown off, and our climbing rope was being whipped around and catching on things. So many times Ray and I were stuck because the rope between us had whipped around and caught on a cornice, and we were afraid to go out. You can't walk out on a cornice. It's funny, they're strong in one sense because we couldn't pull the rope to break it free, but if you go out and step on a cornice, it'll often just break free, and you'll fall very badly. So what a pain in the neck that was, walking along the summit ridge. Peter did much better than I did on the climb today.
No.
Peter was just absolutely amazing. He was so strong and competent and looked like he was a very experienced mountaineer. And, this altitude, the nominal altitude of the mountain, we started at 12,100. Is what the guide said, and we went to 16,067. But there's some weird effect of the altitude here in Antarctica, and a lot of people have said that really the perceived altitude is a couple thousand or more feet higher. And that's certainly what I experienced, because for me now, with the acclimatization I've done, when I was at 16,000 in Mexico in March, I didn't even feel anything. I felt a little bit at 18,000 when I did that 18,600 foot Orizaba. But today, boy, the last 2 hours, it was like a death march. It was take one step, breathe five times, and say a prayer that you could take the next step. That went on for me for at least 2 or 3 hours. And Ray was having terrible difficulties with his face mask and his goggles, and both Ray and my goggles were completely opaque with ice.
And mine.
And yours too?
Yeah.
By the time we got up to the summit, and that was really kind of treacherous, because we had to walk. It's not really rock climbing, but you had to, actually use your hands sometimes to meander up and down through these rocks on the ridge. It wasn't just snow, and it was a very sharp drop on both sides, and we couldn't see where we were going. We were looking through opaque goggles, and I was just trying to see in the 10% bottom of the goggle that was not iced over. So all three of us had trouble with that.
Looking to the right of my goggle, which was pretty much the only part that didn't have iced over. Actually, it was more like a couple of millimeters of visualization. And I just looked down, and all of a sudden there's this cornice and 1,000-foot drop. And I could have easily just kept going and walked through that. I was roped in, and luckily the bottom of my goggles had a little bit more opaqueness than the top, so I was able to just kind of stare at the rope. And for the last 2 hours, and also the 2 hours after the summit, I was able to just look at the rope and follow that. So I really didn't get much good views of anything during the hike, and I'll pretty much have to take everyone's word that we actually got to the summit.
We were out there for how long? 10.5 hours was the length of the climb. It was a long, long day.
When you're on the street.